Hey, friend! Last time we practiced composing and decomposing numbers, or making and breaking numbers. But did you know there are many different ways to compose and decompose numbers? Today we are going to practice composing and decomposing the number six. Let's get started! Today, we are going to use snap cubes to find different ways to compose and decompose the number six. But that's not all. We are going to write addition and subtraction sentences to match. Let's get started. Let's start with one snap cube. How many more snap cubes would we need to add to make six? We can count on to find out. If we add another snap cube, we have two, now three, four, five, and six. Now we have two parts that compose the number six. One part is one, and the other part is one, two, three, four, five. We found our first way to compose six. What will the addition sentence say? Remember, addition sentences always follow a pattern. Part plus part equals whole. So 1 plus 5 equals 6. Awesome! Let's find another way to make 6. Let's start with two snap cubes this time. To find out how many more cubes we need to make 6, we need to add cubes and count on. We have 2 in this part. Now we have 3, 4, 5, and 6. Great! Here are our two parts. 2 here, and 1, 2, 3, 4 here. Wow! We're getting better at this composing numbers thing. We found a new way to make 6. 2 and 4. What will our addition sentence say? Part plus part equals whole. 2 plus 4 equals 6. Awesome! Let's find one more way to compose 6. We started with one cube, then two cubes. Now let's start with 3 cubes. Perfect! Now we just need to add cubes and count on until we get to 6. Here we have 3, now 4, 5, and 6. We have our two parts. 3 cubes are in the first part, and 1, 2, 3 cubes in the second part. We found our third way to make 6, and both parts are 3. Time to write our number sentence. What do you think it is? 3 plus 3 equals 6. Great job! We found 3 ways to compose or make the number 6. Now we're going to do something silly and decompose or break the numbers we just made. I'll show you how. Here you can see all 3 ways we composed the number 6. One part is in blue and the other part is in green. We also have the number sentences we wrote right above. Let's take a closer look at the first one. We composed the number 6 by putting 1 and 5 together. The addition sentence says, 1 plus 5 equals 6. Our job is now to decompose it or break it apart. All we need to do is separate the two parts. There we go. Now we took 1 cube away from the set of 6. How can we write a subtraction sentence to match this? Remember, subtraction sentences always follow a pattern. Whole minus part equals part. So, what is our whole? Good! 6 is our whole, and which part did we take away from 6? 1. Great job! So, 6 minus 1 equals 5. Great job! Let's try one more. 2 plus 4 equals 6. To decompose this set of 6, we need to take away one part. There we go! We took away 2. Now we have 2 parts, 2 and 4. What number will come first in our subtraction sentence? Our whole, 6. And which part did we take away? 2. So 6 minus 2 equals 4. Wow, friend! You did an amazing job! We practiced finding different ways to compose and decompose numbers. We also wrote addition and subtraction sentences to match. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time. Hey, hey.